Engine starting procedure. Engine inspection before starting the engine. To ensure the loco is properly secured, apply handbrake and wooden wedges. Ensure that the throttle handle of both cabs control console in idle, reverser handle center, run isolate switch in isolate position. Check that the level of fuel oil is sufficient. Check that the level of compressor oil is sufficient. Check that the level of fuel oil is sufficient. Check that the level of governor oil is sufficient. Check that the level of water level is sufficient. Ensure that no one is working on the engine, generator room, compressor room, in other cab, etc., and all doors are closed. Ensure that the MU engine stop button is in run position in both cabs on control console. For reset, press green portion inside. Ensure that the engine overspeed trip mechanism is in normal condition. Ensure that the governor low lube oil shutdown plunger is in reset condition. Ensure that the crankcase, oil pan, pressure and low water pressure detector reset buttons are in reset condition, pressed inside. Check time and date of loco shutdown from engine logbook. If loco has been shut down for more than 48 hours, don't start the engine and contact home shed for advice. Ensure that starting fuse is properly intact. On completion of engine inspection, now the engine can be started. Firstly, close the battery knife switch. Make one cab in working mode and other cab in non-working mode. Working cab. Auto brake handle should be in run position. Direct brake handle should be in FS position. Lead and trail switch to be in lead position. Switch on all circuit breakers off circuit breaker panel in following sequence. First black, then white and yellow at last. When computer circuit breaker is on, then display screen appears. On that display screen, then press menu, then select data meter, then select starting system and ensure TLPR is in on position. Then switch on control and FP slide switch on working cab. Make sure that GF and ERS switches are off. Turn the FP ES switch lever to prime and hold. Normally 10 to 20 seconds, if there until the fuel flows clear and free of bubbles in the return fuel side glass and then release it. Turn the FPES switch lever to engine start and hold it there until the engine starts and speed increases to lower idle RPM 200. Do not crank for more than 20 seconds. After holding the engine RPM above 200, release the FPES button. Moving procedure of dual cab loco. Check and ensure all parameter on monitor and gauges like MR, ER, BC, BP and also check AFI should be 0. Insert reverser handle in neutral and move it to desired direction. Switch on ER switch and GFS switch of working cab. Bring BL key to on position. Move throttle from idle to nauseous position and ensure deviation of TE meter. Gradually release direct brake and ensure the movement of loco.